Ready? All right. 4, 3, 2, 1.
I love our intros because they're so unscripted. Good evening, everyone.
Good night.
This is Mr. Belin. I've got my sexy voice tonight because I have two of the most beautiful ladies around me, and I'm feeling good. Now, I'm just playing, yo. What up? This is Mr. Belin. You know what it is. Pillow Talk. AB.
Welcome.
Oh, man. We having a good time over here. You have my lovely wife.
Having an amazing time.
It's Saturday night, and look where I'm at. Y'all could have been anywhere in the world, but you're here with me. I could have been somewhere, but I'm here, and I'm happy. All right? Pillow Talk. I don't even know what episode, no matter no more, we shooting. It's out 9, 10, 11, 12.
11
every week, you know where to come. So, wow, every week you know it'll come. See what this do right here? I got caramel and chocolate. Hey, what's that, a Reese's? That's a Reese's. We're sitting here with our lovely guest for the evening. We're going to have such a great episode. We didn't even want to do our segment separate and then let her come on. Just get in there. Get your sexy ass in the bed with us right now. You know you want to get your sexy ass on the bed. Yeah, cuddle up and get comfortable. Tonight's episode is success in the workplace versus success in the bedroom.
Yeah.
How can we make both work, right? I want to be successful at work, make money, make a living, save, acquire things. I also want my sex life at home in the bed to be equally successful. Getting what I want, making sure I'm satisfied and my partner is satisfied. So we're going to get to it. But first, how are you, darling? It's Saturday night. How you feeling? How was your day?
I'm feeling good.
This is very soft.
Another day.
This is the soft ass. I'm sorry, go ahead.
How was your day?
I can't focus. My day, I did it. I hosted the baby shower today. Actually, I was the setup man I was the driver.
I'll tell you everything.
The driver, the setup man. The DJ, the photographer, and the host.
Multitasking. You know
because people don't plan properly, so I was multitasking. But it was a success because I don't know how to fail when it comes to things like that.
Right now.
So we had a good time, and I'm here now having an even better time.
So you're a one-stop party shop. Everything.
Now, BK Blue. Yeah. By the way, BK Blue 88, that's the name.
Yes. How was
your day?
Oh, it was great. It was good. It was fun.
Okay.
It was fun.
Now, I know it's the middle of fashion. So for those who don't know, BK Blue has, again, someone we've known for years. Mm-hmm. We met while we were all heavily in the modeling world and fashion world. Right, all of us. Well, I think I have one or two. You know me, 55 kids. So we've known each other for a while. And now I know you still model.
Yes.
But now you've also evolved into a designer. Yes. Tell us about your clothing line.
My swimwear line is called Accidental Creations Swimwear. It's only 2 years old, so I'm still having fun with it because I'm still perfecting it. Like I look at the creations that I've had from my first line until now, and it's like a complete change. So I'm always trying to control something. And the funny thing is, I watched Project Runway this last season, and a lot of the designers had problems with the swimwear.
Right, it's on
right with the swimwear. Right, so it was really fun to have.
Question for you, again, because you said that when you were watching about Project Runway, out of all of the different things you could have designed, what made you choose, or made you say, I want to do swimsuit?
Well, my boyfriend, he had his own swimwear line, which was named Kiki, and he was also a photographer. So it kind of branched off of that because he always, you know, guys, you like skin. And then on top of
it, it only covers your neck.
Right. And you know, you always hear models and they say, oh, I can't wear that. I have somebody with on the arms or something like that. Blah, blah, blah.
Not a real model. But then again, I feel like if you're not getting compensated, then I'm not going to wear some shit that can possibly compromise my shit and I'm not getting compensated.
Right.
So I understand models who would say that.
That too.
You know, models hate to pay.
It's more than, you know, just wanting to shoot. It's more than shoot.
Right.
So then I was, after my concussion, because I had a concussion. Oh, yeah, okay. So the story is three years ago, because I was construction worker too. So 3 years ago, I got into a concussion, changing the linen on the bottom bunk. So I thought I cleared the bump and banged the hell out of my head. Banged my head, got a concussion. He told me I couldn't leave the house because I was going to school and of course I was using machinery.
Right.
So he was like, no, you're just gonna have to make up. So I was like, so if you can't leave, let me get you. I went to a sewing machine and just started making swimwear, but in 2 weeks I had a whole line of
colors
and shapes, no mannequin, no training, just got it.
Wow.
Nice swim. And yeah, and then eventually I just kept getting better and better, and it looks good.
And it has been successful,
yeah.
Because I know you have some adult film stars that have been seen wearing this stuff, some prominent urban models that are always in it, and I know you have a multitude of and a body of work with a wide variety of photographers as well. And so I consider that very successful. And that's why I wanted to get you on this show to talk about success. Because when I look at your career path, your growth.
Being that you knew me since I was 18.
Yes. I see. Right. And so I want to see how you measure that success and then compare it to success in bed. Alright, Ray, I want you to be honest too. The viewers, we like honesty over here. So we're gonna get right into this episode because at the end of the day it's a good vibes right here. We're having a good time. As usual, you know we gotta pay these bills. So we'll be right back. We got a quick commercial. I don't even know who it is this week. You know what I mean? But y'all keep sending us y'all stuff. Like we're gonna get y'all on. We get to promote everybody. I got Pillow Talk on. We got my man Gator's Work in Progress. Shout out to Gator.
Remember to subscribe.
Gator Fitness, yes. Remember to click subscribe. Remember to like. Remember to comment. We need more comments. I want to hear from you, the viewers.
And you guys, this is what we're here for.
Yeah, or just let us know how we do. You know what I mean? So we'll be back. It's Pillow Talk, Mr. Belin. Beautiful, beautiful BK Blue. It's caramel, it's chocolate, it's Reese's. I'm the peanut butter, baby. Holding it all together. And that's some twists, first of all. Caramel, and peanut butter. I just realized it's a twist. All right? And I'm the peanut butter holding it together. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.
one.
PDA.
Okay.
Well. You kissed me.
We're gonna do that again, all right?
No, I'm keeping it. We're rolling live. This pillow talk. And my wife is over here kissing me on the neck. I turned to kiss her back. She always complains about PDA.
About the PDA and his. And now
I how's the shot, brother? Do I look good or I look uncomfortable? I look good.
Thank you.
Oh, trying to change the subject? No, I'm making sure we I've been doing tech before we came back. That was a commercial. Okay, follow. You good? Yeah, having a good time. Are you having a good time?
You having a good time.
I'm having a great time.
Yes.
All right, then. So let's get into this. Success versus.
What's your success?
Oh yeah. Shout out to my producer, Cool Ass Trev, gave me the shirt. He said, you know what? You should send a message to a lot of the guys out here that don't have their shit together. I said, well, what do you mean? He said, put this on. So if you guys can read, it says, sit down and learn from the master. What am I the master of? I don't know. A lot of things. But if you listen, Mike could help you. But you got something? You know what I'm the master of? You know what I'm the master of?
And some
you know? I'll tell you.
He's a multitasker.
I don't know multitasker. I'm good at most.
Multitasker.
Yes, you can see Casta. All right. Success in the workplace versus success in the bedroom. So earlier we were talking, you are, I call you an entrepreneur. I call you a self-employed person because you do the construction and you mentioned that and you should be very proud of that. There's no shame in none of the work, none of the work that you do. Exactly. I think women in construction is dope.
Yes.
So you got that model, I would say novice photographer or like a freelance photographer. You get the high lens or you just
keep it still? I took up photography in high school. That was fun. So like I do it from time to time. I can't, you know, do certain angles. If I see something, I do have my own camera. I will take a picture. I'm more of a natural light.
I've been with him for so long that I should know something about him.
Ten years.
Ten years is a long time.
Y'all, common law.
Yeah. So, with you now, do you still do construction?
Yes.
So, it's safe to say at any point in time, you can have three jobs. Construction, model, even if you're modeling your own stuff.
Right.
And then also a designer.
And a model.
And a model. And a model because you do have two children.
Yes. Wait, two people.
Right.
Anyways, yeah.
Look at that.
I was like,
so, with all of that, how does your work schedule affect your sex schedule? And by that, I don't mean if you may have it where you actually do plan sex. Okay, go ahead. So you know the question.
Yeah, it's definitely non-existent. Only because like I have so much, like you said, the construction could be from 7 to 3, and depending on where I'm at, it's like an hour and a half. Because sometimes I don't get the job in 7.
Right.
I'll get the job in the city.
Travel.
And that's travel.
Right.
That's travel. But we try to get it in. You know, like if we, like on the weekends, like now that the kids are out of town, like we're trying to get it in.
Right, that's like any other. That's like us. We know certain times when we know like it's definitely gonna go down. Because you know when we do most of our smashing? When the kids are hit. Nothing like a Saturday morning when I know they drooling because they stayed up all damn night on their damn iPad. She likes to sleep on the side. She loves to be side now. I just found that out doing the show. She's a side me. So now I just slide it from the side. Now that I lost a couple of pounds, I can actually get it from the side. The belly was preventing that. Not the length of the dick. The size of the belly was like, nigga, you want to do this, you got to lose 10
pounds. Oh, shit.
So now I can side successfully. I'm a successful side. Side humps. So do you guys have to plan 6 days?
No.
Is it, so it's still spontaneous?
It is.
Because I think spontaneity makes it.
I mean, that's how I got pregnant the first time. That was on me. That was on me. Woke up one morning, I was like, you know how y'all guys have the morning wood? I need some of that.
Yeah,
but,
right.
Yeah, that's what I had. That's how I got pregnant the first time. Right.
How do you rate your success right now? I know we can be our worst critics. But you have a lot going on. You are successful in the construction world. You are successful as a model. You are successful as an upcoming fashion designer. Rate that, rate your success from 1 to 10.
I'm going to say like a 9.5
as well. Yeah! Because you said we are our biggest critic. You know, like 2 years ago when I started construction, I was out there in Staten Island, and I'm still in love with it. I want to go back. Loved it. And now that I literally bumped into doing the swimwear, and you know, I was discouraged before when my boyfriend sat there and spoke about it, saying you should get into it. And I was like, eh, I made like 2. And then the next year, that's when I sat there and I was like, all right, it was full force for me. Right. Because I already had that taste for it. And it became a passion because then you saw a lot of women actually saying, hey, I like this cut. If I was old, I was doing, and that's what I want for me to feel. To be bold, to be daring, to be a showstopper as far as like anything is concerned. Like, when you put on my swimsuit, I want you to feel like
a boss.
A boss, exactly. You know what I mean?
And you got something for me with my gut. You got design. You got to take some measurements in that.
You got to cut around the gut.
Cut around the gut.
Okay, in between the gut. You
know.
And accentuate what, you know. Well, I always sit there and say, you're the high waisted.
Yeah,
high waisted is always dope. Like, I kind of start. I'm sorry.
Yes. Okay, here we go.
Awesome. Especially with the prints and the patterns.
Money, you know.
By you.
You mentioned that, you know, I'm going to call him your husband.
That's fine. So, yes, it is.
You mentioned that he said, encouraged you, like, you should do this.
Yeah, he did.
How important is that? Because I think that's important that your partner does support your work life.
Definitely.
As well.
It's great. Because the first thing you need to know is how to find time to do what you have to do. When I first got into construction, the first thing I was told was try to figure out how your work schedule and your family. Like, you have to get that support system online. Because if you fall off your support system, what's the thing? Like, you got to get back on
it. It doesn't allow you to fall off.
Exactly.
Especially when you have a family. Really, you have to do. Sometimes you don't want to get up, you got to get up.
Funny thing is, with my boys, that I would put something on the mannequin, and once I start sewing, and they'll see a pattern, you'll see how it's going. They actually,
oh,
it's
really
nice.
It's
a really good feeling.
From an 8 and a 6 year old?
Yes.
Man, listen. You didn't get on with my mom?
Yeah.
Right.
Yes, thank you.
And I made them swimming trunks.
Oh.
And they loved it.
And I got to make them another couple of pairs of.
So, for you, what is the ideal percentage of, you know, balance, family, work, personal, I guess, sex, like, to, like, you know, did you try to devote 20-20-20, or is it because now, or 20-20-20, that would be 100%. But, you know, like, right now, I know maybe you have a little tunnel vision because you're really focused on things. So, like, what's your percentage right now? What's your ideal?
I just want to eat as even as possible, to be honest with you. Like, if I can get it in and get the sex in as a little bit more than, you know, but sometimes the frustration of work life, being a mom and stuff like that, it definitely bothers you. You're like, just please just give me an hour. So,
right.
Let me see how I feel. I like a dinner, you know, maybe a beer, a cup of wine or something. You know what I mean? Like, sometimes it's just like, yo, just let me go to sleep.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You may want to do it, and it's just like, I just need you.
Right.
Yeah,
let me recoup first.
Right.
Exactly. I complain with you. I don't go outside. Give me some time. Yeah. It's hard sometimes. And, you know, you just have to find a balance, you know, and it takes time.
It does.
You know, you've been doing it for 2 years or you've been doing it for the modeling and this and that. But it also takes time to just find a balance of what or how much percentage you're going to put into something. And, well, even for me, it's a role too. Like, we're, you know, still trying to find that balance. And so I was like, you know, is it once a month that we're going to have this day that the kids are going to the babysitter? This is our date night.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this day, you know, no matter what it is, of course, when we live, it's just spending quality time in the house. Like, I think it's important to make sure that you're, you know, giving that devoted time to your spouse, to your kids. And then, like, the work and everything else, that would be there. But I need definitely to make sure there's balance for family.
Right.
You know?
So with all that said, how do you rate your sex life? I was gonna say that for a ten for ten. I'm gonna be perfectly with my nails. And like, this nigga really spent the sleep on. And she go right to sleep. Me, it took 8 hours because I gotta think
gotta
about the show and everything else.
You gotta think about the world and how everybody else is doing the world before you go to. I go right to sleep.
I'm totally oblivious
to
the picture.
I'm the first one to wake up. I do fantastic penis presentation. Well, wait, but then they're always
all
early morning
sex. Always early morning sex.
He claim I like to sleep, which I do like to sleep. You might
need to have a
switch.
I'm
lying.
So I had to wake up early one day. God, she grabbing me so bad. Every time I look at her, I call her cell phone and let the cell phone ring. Star 6-7 this nigga. Let the random.
Wait, they still do Star 6-7?
No, he's just lying. He can wake me up. He can wake me up with the penis inside of me, and that's fine.
Right.
You know, if you just wake me up with some other shit. No, I'll wake me up. But if you slide it in the side of me, I'll be fine. I'll be like, oh shit, oh what? Oh snap. And I'll go right the hell back to sleep.
See this? Yeah, now we go through spells. Ours be sometimes it be a 10, a lot of times it really do be low. Between the kids and work and
especially with the modeling, with the modeling, with the, you get what you're saying, right? No, I'm sticking with it. I can't, the light is still wet.
Right. It has dips to free.
I have to work on it. Yeah.
It's not always you.
You can't be having a show and then I gotta, you know.
Listen, when it's on 10, it's on 15. I think the audience know that much. Like, we make up for this shit. You know what I mean? Pillow talk party. September 26th. Yeah, there you go. Now, we got this right from the top. That being said, like, so with you as a model, you as a swimsuit designer, the easiest way now to gain notoriety, to gain recognition of your work, it's through social media, right? So you have to get out there, promote, hashtag, and all this stuff. Do you think it's easier or more difficult to maintain a relationship with social media?
Let me tell you about this.
Because you got a personal page and you got your business.
I do.
And I know you get hit up on them.
Yeah,
but I know they slide safe into the DM.
Safe?
Slide in the
same, same. No, right.
No,
fuck that shit.
Same.
Fuck that shit. They can slide in and you're out. Yeah. Like, it's not. Fuck that shit. You've gotten the DMs with, it's just like, hey, dick. Yeah, no.
Okay. It's
no,
crazy.
Oh, and then there's no response. Block.
Okay.
So.
That's how you handle it. Let me do the finger for it. That's how you handle it.
But, like, when it comes to, like, it also depends on what you put out. So, as far as the swimwear is concerned, I'm always trying to do something different. And there's someone nowadays, not when back when, you know, the swimwear wasn't, or, you know, it was per century, 10 years ago, when we were men. It's like.
Very misogynistic.
It was. Mm-hmm. So, what it is now trying to figure out how do we get on Caucasian level. You know what I mean?
And being respected.
Sorry, yeah. Put on the Caucasian level. So what can we do to make everything look Caucasian level? You know what I mean?
It's the quality.
Right, that's
the quality of the show. It's the presentation.
Right.
The
presentation. You know what I mean? So it's more like, yo, the pigs are dope. It's more like, yo, you're beautiful. Thank you for being the melody queen that you are. It's more respect.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, and but so, you still get the older guys. God, the older guys.
Yeah.
Where they're like, ooh, the nipples look nice in this picture. That's I had to delete one of those pictures. I want to be honest with you. Is that all you see? I'm like.
Well, you still got it out here. And, you know, people make sex taboo. People make nudity, you know, certain style of dress. They make the dish out of it.
Yes,
they can't handle it. Because of their own insecurities. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, that's all y'all. Like, we have to just be us and being us naturally.
Right.
It's
one way that you can sit there and be like, oh, this is like, hat out here to the world, but then it's a way that you can sit there and be like, this art is beautiful. You understand me? So,
we went to recently.
The Robin B.
It was a lot of naked women, but it was good.
Some had stretch marks, some had their body done.
It was
whatever.
The way she caught the vision of them.
Yeah.
It was very artistic.
Right.
And that's what people in this world need. I understand. Sex sounds.
Of course.
Got it.
Of course.
You understand me? That's how you get a lot of your likes, your viewers, your followers, and stuff like that.
And it's unfortunate.
It is unfortunate. But the thing is, like, look beyond what is actually there. Look at
the
whole picture.
Right.
Look at the content. Because at the end of the day, the content is what really sticks in your head.
Yeah.
You know, not just, oh, her nipples are there, and then a few swipes over. Those are nipples, too. So, let's get it together.
So, that, what advice can you give to men, women, couples on maintaining a healthy relationship, sex relationship at home, sex life, advice on balancing
it? I think it's the key is support. It's support. Once you support, it, you get that help that you need, and like, it's easier to maintain what you need to maintain at work. And once you see all that stuff at home, he's sitting there cooking, he's taking care of kids, he's helping more homework, you know, stuff like that.
Shout out to your man for holding it down. That's dope. Yo, we see you, brother. And we celebrate you as a great father, great man, and supporting your lady in all of her endeavors. I forgot
to
tell
you. Like, you know, yes.
But, you know, you can't do without them.
I wouldn't have my babies without
them.
Exactly.
So, look, that was that. We're gonna take another short break. Let's show up as a commercial of that. It's everybody's favorite part.
Yes.
It's the 10 for 10. Because she don't know what we got coming for her.
Yes.
But it's coming.
Mm-hmm. Time to subscribe, like,
appreciate it. We'll be back.
One.
Yo, yo.
Here we go.
10 for 10, y'all. Favorite part of the show. We nice and cozy with BK Blue 88.
All
right. Are you ready?
No, but go ahead.
Okay, look right into the camera. Are you ready? All right, you keep looking at the camera. I'm just going to look at these questions. Question number one.
Question number one.
How do you prefer yourself? Shave? Or unshaved? Yeah. Hey, like it. Question number two. Fuck with the music on or fuck with the TV on?
Or no music.
All fucking silent.
TV. TV, what's on the TV?
A movie. Comedy, romance, or horror? Ah! Or whatever, anime?
Whatever's interesting on Netflix.
So you're not a music person. You like to hear explosions.
I mean, I don't mind the music, but you know, I usually turn the TV on.
Okay. How often do you masturbate?
Twice every 2 weeks.
Once a week?
Not even. No. Sometimes it's twice during 1 week.
And then you go for a whole week cold shoulder.
Right. Yeah.
I don't masturbate a lot.
Right, exactly.
He's fucking lying. He's lying.
I train my dick.
Oh,
I don't masturbate.
Yeah,
you're getting to that episode. I train my dick.
Right. Yeah, okay. Toys and all that.
41, I keep my shit in shape.
All right, baby, go ahead. Next question. Next question.
Favorite sex position.
Ooh.
Oh. Now, are you a back archer or are you a lay down and stretch the head?
I'm definitely a back archer.
You can't.
She's flexing.
Yeah.
All right. Hope you guys are taking notes.
No, well, nobody needs to take notes because you know.
Hey, listen.
Hey,
all right. What sex act would you never do again?
Never.
You want to plead the fifth? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Never. Right. Like I wouldn't do anything if I was uncomfortable in the first place.
No. Sometimes you could have did something and been like, "Ooh, I didn't like that.
I made a mistake." That was the person you made a mistake with.
Okay. I like it. Round a face.
Hell.
Or get eaten from behind.
Oh. All the time?
Damn.
Not all the time, but.
So you straight. You straight joystick in the nigga face.
I mean, sometimes you have to make a point. Like, if you want to put your face there, don't put it off. So I put it for you.
Okay. Like it. What were y'all?
Taking notes?
No.
I think too. Having a really great time on this episode.
I'm a host. I'm doing my job there. I'm getting to the issues.
Yeah.
Ready.
Ready.
This is number seven. Number seven. Spit, swallow, or wear it on your face.
Oh, Oh, you forgot one. Blow bubbles. Just saying.
So you blow a bubble?
Blow bubbles.
So I should have said, spit, swallow, wear it on your face, or play with it.
Yeah.
Play with it.
Yeah.
Over there,
she is nasty.
She is nasty.
Like,
you just talk. Here's the random question.
I'll be burning. I'll be like, oh, my eye pink, and they go to work. I'm like, come here, you okay? Some packets got a little coming, all right? It ain't contagious, though.
That ain't for me. I know how I spray.
Uncontrollably.
I have great aim and precision.
That hole is, you know.
How we get on?
Anyways, go ahead. Position.
How do you put your toilet paper on the roll? Because we argue about this shit all the time.
I do it where it's coming from the back.
So it rolls out from the back.
Yes.
Wait, what? So how is that?
The way you do it.
Yeah, you pull it. That's how I do it.
I definitely need Joel to comment on that one. Because I'm a pointy person where it is here, the roll is here, and it comes out this way, not coming back this way.
Then I still don't have all of it in the toilet paper. That's how it does. When you try to wipe before you go in there, half of it is in there garbage. You gotta put away
from
the
control.
That's the child, not me.
You gotta put
from underneath to get
more
control.
That's not getting into this. DM a comment. I'm a pussy. They from the back.
Hey.
All right. Question number 9. You're doing good.
Question number 9.
If you could take a naked.
10 dicks.
Wow. Who your top 10 dicks to? If you can send a naked selfie to one celebrity, who would it be?
I know. Shit.
Pass.
No.
Alright, if you can take 10 dicks in a day.
Right, if you can take. Right.
How many dicks do you take in one day? Overtime.
Oh, hell no.
At one time? At different times?
Oh,
or
my gosh.
How many dicks can you handle in one session?
Hypothetically.
I'll answer the photo. It would have to be Gabrielle Union. She's a bad joke.
See, you find out something new out of it. I would have never thought that one. You got a thing for Gabrielle. Shout out to Gabrielle Union. Ain't no way, wait. Y'all got to know the way to shit too.
Social media is a hell of a thing.
Shout out to Dwayne and Gabby, yo. Y'all a dope ass couple too out here. Like, I like that. You know what I'm saying? Real couples out here having a good time. You can tell they have.
Yes.
All right, last question.
Last question.
It's coming from Camille.
Okay.
So,
yes.
Pretend you were fucking Mr. Bell. In your sexiest voice, what would you say?
The body language tells it all. Since you don't want to answer the question, you gave me a chance.
Now you got to show us. Hey.
Now show me some body language.
That's the side.
Oh,
side.
That's, see that? That's where that stomach, I lost the weight. See the side, see the side, dude? See the side, dude?
We're gonna get in trouble.
Hey, listen. That was the 10 for 10. Thank you to BK Bootsy. That's what we need. Somebody being a good sport. That was, we just having fun out here. It's designed to wake y'all up. Y'all gotta stop being afraid of talking about sex. You gotta stop being afraid of asking and telling what you want sexual, like what you want in a relationship. Open your mouth at the end of the day. Y'all make things taboo out here. Y'all ain't just having a good conversation. On the record sheets, I purposely did not buy any shit. Exactly.
My mother does it though. She's old fashioned.
And that's what she
does. Yo. At the end of the day, like, yo, if we could get up here on camera and loosen up, like, yo, y'all gotta reevaluate y'all shit. We trying to help y'all out here, man.
I'd like to be easier, relationships would be easier, talk about it, be honest about it, we're all humans.
Right. Any last words, DK? Perfect.
Just follow me on the ground, DK88, yes, Swimwear, Accidental_Creations, NYC.
Yeah, please do. Bathing suits is sexy. Yeah, we're going to do another. It's cold now, but now we're going to get some episodes.
It's hot somewhere.
It's hot somewhere. We're going to go on location. We're going to do a little talk on the beach. We call it beach talk.
Beach talk.
I just want to see all of them glistening asses in bathing suits. I'm old now. Getting old, baby.
I can't.
How much you recognize it? Anyways.
Mrs. Belin, anything else? Last words?
No, thank you so much for being here with us tonight.
Give your disclaimer, what they gotta do.
You know, you guys gotta subscribe, like, comment, concerns, tap, all of that. We want feedback, guys. We want to interact more with you guys. Tell us what you want to hear from us, and vice versa.
Pillow party,
Yes, again, pillow party. Listen, let's be honest. 95% of y'all, whoever watches the show, y'all ain't gonna be here. Take the doubts and dream. But you will be able to see it live. Because we are streaming that one live. The entire party. We're doing interviews, having pillow fights, and contests, and all kind of other stuff. Just imagine a whole venue filled with nothing but sexy people and sexy predominant. For the guys, if you think you're coming in here with basketball shorts, if you come in here with them on, I guarantee you, I'm going to have three women at the door to take your shit off. And I hope y'all niggas got your meat game on point because you come in here with the Frankie Franks, the Viennas.
It's okay, you can have a
girl. I don't know what that's about. For the ladies, you know, obviously we want you to be, but we grown and sexy over here, enough said. You know what I'm saying? But again, be respected or be comfortable. You know, it's no body shame. Well, there's no judgment over here. No judgment over here, all right? Come as you are. And I mean that either way you want to take it. Come as you are. All right? Don't let that go over your head. I'm Mr. Belin.
Mrs. Belin.
Yeah.
another episode in the books. Hope y'all enjoyed it. We'll see y'all next week.
Yeah. Okay, I'm happy.